Weather events and extreme climate pose a significant threat to infrastructure systems, to communities, and ultimately to the individuals who rely upon the viability of those systems. And the impacts of these types of events are only getting worse. In 2017, in the United States, we saw 16 events that cost $1 billion in losses or more per event. Around the world, it was 29 events. This is a significant increase over previous decades. So these trends provide significant motivation for our group here at Argonne National Laboratory to study the impacts of climate change.
Argonne National Laboratory is located near Chicago, and it's home to about 1,300 scientists and engineers. Our researchers here at Argonne have access to the top-notch facilities and resources that are provided to us by the Department of Energy. And these tools allow us to do really top-notch work on a variety of different topics and problems facing the nation today. One of these problems is climate change.
When we think about climate change, most people generally talk about global climate change. What is the average change in global temperature? What is the average change in precipitation? But you really have to think about what effect it has on a region. For example, a change in Chicago may be quite different from the change in Houston. So this kind of local change is important for decision making, mitigation, developing mitigation strategies. So our focus at Argonne has been on this regional climate change, or changes at these local scales and how they differ from global scale.
Argonne can offer several different important aspects in tackling climate change in a way that is actionable. First of all, we focus on North America, but contrary to other organizations that focus on a large scale, we are able to go more detail in what happens, what we call high resolution models. Imagine that most of the models are now 100 kilometers in resolution. If you think of a grid, we're working at 12 kilometer scale, which is really starting to begin to provide really actionable information to whoever needs to make decisions. We're also going deeper than that, and we're working now on a 4 kilometer resolution scale model.
Along with the high resolution climate data sets, we also have the capability and expertise to evaluate the physical impacts of these changes at local scales. So with the environmental modeling, we can project flooding at neighborhood scale over large multi-state regions. We have also developed advanced statistical techniques for projecting the extremes in wind precipitation and temperature that were used in the study. The advantage of being at Argonne is that we can leverage the supercomputing facilities we have here for performing these kinds of analysis over the entire country. So what does this work mean for AT&T and other partners who sponsor this type of research? Let's say, for example, a company is considering building some infrastructure near a coastline. We can give them information on which parts of the coast are more at risk from flooding in a future climate.
Our expertise and our tools allow us not only to do great technical work and scientific work, but also allow us to be the integrators of a lot of different components to this. And that's why we're really striving to be the place to go to forge collaborations between academia, for example, other researchers at National Lab, ourselves, industry, and other stakeholders.
Through our collaboration with industry and with other stakeholders, the climate modeling we do here at Argonne has already informed infrastructure resilience projects across a number of sectors in different parts of the country. In California, we helped develop models to better plan for wildfire risks to electric utilities. In the Northeast, we helped identify hurricane and sea level rise impacts to coastal energy infrastructure. We've also helped some of the country's largest cities better plan for heat wave impacts to communities and impacts to the electric grid. And it's through collaborations like these that we best connect our climate science and our infrastructure expertise with the needs of industries and communities.
The interesting fact is that when you do a project like trying to evaluate the impacts from climate change and the risk from climate change to a company like AT&T, we really need to find out what actually they are interested in. So we worked with AT&T to identify the kind of climate impacts and risks that is posed to their business as a result of the changing climate. So we did a study over the southeastern United States where they had a lot of infrastructure and possible impacts of climate change to their operations. So we produced the output and uncertainties that they actually could use for this purpose.
We're not only interested in safeguarding our current infrastructure, but we want to also ensure that tomorrow's infrastructure is resilient and doesn't become prematurely obsolete as the climate around it changes. One of the ways that we do this is to ensure that decision makers have actionable information that's based upon the best available science.